So today I want to talk about the pros and cons of keeping this 2009 Toyota Sienna, which we have been using for two camping seasons now. Bought this in June of 2020, traveled all across the country with it that summer, 2020. And then this past summer, we had tons of great times camping all around the state of Maine, just having an absolute blast in this thing. This 2009 Toyota Sienna has definitely served its purpose. Number one, it was an introduction to us as to, you know, how Lisa and I would enjoy just getting out, having the freedom to have a van, drive around with a bed with us, everything that we need. This is pretty much self-containing. You know, we carry food, clothes, cooking gear, and everything that we need. A couple of things that this thing lacks is, number one, a restroom, a toilet, as far as, you know, you're sleeping someplace in the middle of the night. Not a huge issue when we're camping and things like that, but some of the places that we sleep that are a little bit more public, it's definitely become an issue. So this thing is not big enough to do that. I don't know if you can see behind me, but the whole back of this thing, from behind my seat all the way to the tailgate, is bed. There's not a whole bunch of room to put anything else there. You know, all of our supplies that we carry with us, you know, clothes and things like that, all go underneath the bed. But there's definitely no more floor space to add any sort of facility for nighttime interruptions. So that's definitely weighs in with our thought process. You know, and the other thing is it's a little small. If it's raining out, you know, we have to find a canopy. Although we do carry one with us. We do have a roof with us that we can put over a picnic table in case we run into any inclement weather. But we're just looking for something, you know, a little more comfortable. It's, you know, definitely time to trade up, to upgrade this thing. Again, this thing has been just a phenomenal experience for us. Some of the things that we like about this that we would be looking for in a future vehicle, this is a minivan. So number one, that tells you why it's too small. But number two, it's, what's the word I'm looking for? It's very indiscreet. Everybody's got one of these. Here comes one now. I see one coming towards me, and it's going to pull into a driveway up there, so you don't get to see it. But these things are all over the place, so you definitely don't stick out. I don't know if you've ever had a chance to go out in a van and spend some time, and by time I mean, you know, more than just a couple days. We've been out for weeks and over a month. I think 5 weeks was the longest we took off in this thing. But we'll do that now when we go in and, you know, go into a parking lot, especially like a Walmart parking lot, and you see vans and things like that, and you say, we play a little game. Is somebody in there? Is somebody living in there? Or is it, you know, just a family van? With this setup that we have here, I have shown previous videos. What I'll do is I'll put a link to my Toyota Sienna playlist at the end of this video, in case you're interested in seeing any of those. This thing here comes apart in no time and it turns back into a passenger van. So that's one thing that, you know, I mean, the versatility that we would definitely want to maintain with a van. What I think that we're leaning towards getting is, you know, just a step up into like a cargo van, something that has a little bit more floor space, something that's a little bit longer, gives us room to have a bed, and something like that. Especially if it's a cargo van with no seats, I would come up with a better design. This design that I have here for this bed, it doesn't fold. You lift it up, put it in the back. After you take the seats out, if you want to turn it back into a passenger van, you take the bed out and put the seats back in. With a cargo van that doesn't come with any seats, I would come up with a better design, something that would hopefully that would fold up out of the way so that it could be multifunctional, more like a bench type seat during the day and then fold it out into a bed at night. That's where we're at right now, is trying to figure out, are we done with this? It's that time of year. It's middle of November here in Maine. It's getting a little chilly. There's frost on the pumpkin in the morning. We've been getting down below freezing the last few nights. And we will go out and do some cold weather camping. Be nice with a bigger van where we could make ourselves a cup of coffee before we had to get out and face the cold. So we're going to be wrapping it up. You know, like I said, we may get out a couple more times this winter. It was just a good time for us to sit down and think, okay, what do we want to do moving forward? This thing has been wonderful for us. The experiences that we've had, I wouldn't trade this for anything. This old van, 2009, with well over 100,000 miles on it now, has taken us to what we've counted like 8 national parks, a few national lake shores, countless state parks and day trips. This thing's been down to Fenway Park for Red Sox games a few times, and just a great, versatile, all-around van. It's been great when we pulled up to like family cookouts and somebody didn't have something. Oh, hold on, we got that in the van. It's a very freeing feeling to have whatever we need. Whatever we need. Sometimes I'm surprised, you know, if Lee says, oh, well, I know I have that in the van. And sure enough, there it is. So there's stuff in here that I don't even know, but that she's deemed important and has proven that it was important. So, you know, we'll keep you posted. Stay tuned. We've had a blast building this out. And if we get something else, we'll share all those videos with you as well. A little bit more immediate. So tomorrow morning, I am hopping on a plane. And I am going to Jackson, Wyoming. We'll be headed out there to visit with my son, daughter-in-law, grandkids. A bigger trip. My nephew's going to meet us out there. My sister and brother-in-law, Kim and Tim, they've showed up on some of our videos in the past. It's going to be a whole bunch of us out there. My son is career military, and he is swearing in for the last time. This will be his last enlistment that he needs to get to his 20-year. So I'm hoping to take some great shots out there, bring some videos from out there. Thanks for watching. If you don't want to miss those future adventures, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Talk to you again real soon. Thank you.